Hello friends, this is Jay Eichmann doing a quick video on CTE recruitment strategies. I teach at Clovis High School in the construction pathway. This is my ninth year. We've got a pretty good thing going out here, and I wanted to see if I could share some of the things I do with you. First thing I want to talk about is why recruit? It may be that your numbers are good. Something that can also happen when you recruit by increasing numbers is you can then start to pick and choose and then in turn increase the caliber of your students. So even if you have good numbers, you may want to work on increasing the caliber of your students. We all have a passion for what it is we're teaching, and nothing makes teaching better than students who share that passion genuinely. So recruiting can help not only with numbers, but also in increasing the caliber of students. When I think of recruiting, I focus in this order because I believe it gives me the most bang for my buck. I do most of my work with the counselors. Second, I work with students directly, of course, on the recruiting side. And third, parents and community. But I focus my efforts in this order, 1, 2, and 3. And that's how I've broken up this quick little discussion we're having. So let's talk about counselors. The bottom line with your counselors is this: they care about the kids that they oversee. And if they see your program as an asset to their students, then they're going to place students in your program. So the question comes down to, how do they learn about your program? How do they learn to see the value of your program? One of the things I do regularly is I'll go into the counselors' meetings. All of your counselors will have regular meetings. You literally just ask if you can pop in for a quick 5-minute little discussion on the different things you're doing in your program. Another thing I do all the time is send pics and highlights via email. I actually have a group set up of CHS counselors, and when something neat goes on, I send that over. I will often invite the counselors out on the cool days, the days that the students are doing something really neat that's exciting to see. I'll invite the counselors out to see that. And then I pay attention to who the students' counselors are, and if I've got a particularly challenged student, or maybe a student who's had a tough go, I make sure I send success stories when those happen to that student's counselor, because they talk to each other, the counselors do. And finally, I rub elbows with the counselors. As part of my morning routine, I go into the front office, check the mail, and I loop back through the counseling office, and that gives me a chance just to say hi. If there's any kind of success stories, I can share them in person, and it's just a way for them to stay visible, them and I to stay visible to each other. That's how I handle the counselors. The next focus area would be your students. The bottom line on your students, I believe, is this: if you build a meaningful quality curriculum with diverse experiences and interactions, then you will attract students. Students want to learn about the subject that they've signed up for. These are elective classes. They've chosen to be in our classes. And so if we're doing a good job in those classes, then the students will sign up. And they'll tell their siblings and they'll tell their friends. And the opposite is also true. Sometimes we think the students, and some I guess do, want to do nothing. But most of them want a good experience. So in my class, I make sure I do lots of cool projects. It's CTE, learn by doing. Field trips are a pain, but I take them and I do them. If you talk to people in industry, I would bet you half of them who are in industry probably have some motivational experience that they had on a field trip or from a guest speaker, and I do guest speakers as well. Finally, some great industry certifications. The OSHA 10-hour, I believe, is one that we can pay for out of our funding sources. If not, sometimes businesses will help you sponsor. It's $25 per student. It is a lifelong federal certification, and I have had multiple students take my classes because they were excited to have a chance to win, to get their OSHA certification. So students. Another thing about students: have a presence in your student body. Be a part of your campus. So things I do on that: I do campus visible activities. This here is the La Monica Stadium ticket booth. My Construction 2 class designed and framed that, and then we subbed out the stucco. And you can bet I milked the press out on that. We made it in CUSD today. I've got this particular picture on a plaque, and it's up in the guidance counseling office on a plaque like any other trophy that would be up there for any other sport. All the students signed it. Looks really cool. My construction program has been the Valley Champions like 5 years in a row, but a few years back it was an all-girl team that beat all the boy teams. I made a big hoop out of that. That's on a plaque. That's up in the front office, actually right when you walk in. I have a Facebook page just for our construction program, and then it's easy to share that with the school's Instagram and the school's social media, which the kids, a lot of them subscribe to. And then finally, I also do a club. I do a construction club. So all of these things give me a presence in the student body. When I go out to do a project on campus or even just a unit, we do surveying, we're using surveying scopes. I make the students dress in their construction garb. We put on the hard hats, we put on the vests, so that as we're walking about the campus, we're turning heads. And so I would suggest if you have some sort of shirt or uniform, I know Med Careers has their scrubs, you make it a point to have those on and visible on your campus, and that's going to get people chattering. So that's how I do students. Lastly is our parents and community. A lot of overlap here. Social media. We do back to school nights. We have freshman orientation, and I am a presence. Our pathway is present at our orientation nights. We have a table set up. We invite students to come there and demonstrate some things. I've got a bunch of cool awards put out. I mean, we make a showpiece out of it at our back to school nights. We do community wide events. On this next slide here, we did a charity project, got the girls on the front page of the Clovis Independent. I forget what this one was about. We've probably been in the news on TV and in the newspaper and in different trade magazines. I'm not kidding, 20 times. And literally, when you do some of these things, you just work through the district. They have a press release that they can do for you, and the media will show up. A lot of our community has paid good money and is in great support of our programs. And if we invite the press out to cover it, they will gladly come out and cover it. So make it a point to get some press releases, get your name out there in the community. And then finally, we do a big end of year showcase. This here picture, for our pathway, we have at the end of the year, we have between 250 and 300 people show up at our end of year showcase. This is a picture from Kelly's last year. So do things like that. It's a pain, but the time invested will increase your program. You'll enjoy your program better. You'll be proud of your program. You'll get a better caliber of student. So yes, recruiting is additional work, but I do it gladly because it really raises the caliber of my students, and it really gets me connected to the community and to the campus, and really shows the credibility of what we're doing with our students. If you just indulge me for a second, I want to show you one of the things I do is a promo video, really easy to do with Microsoft Movie Maker. You literally just pop a bunch of pictures in there, and you can do other video clips and stuff and attach a music, and off you go. This is with Microsoft Music Maker, and I have it on YouTube.
Song for the broken-hearted.
Clovis High School is offering students interested in construction some hands-on experience.
And it's a whopper. Action News anchor Dale Yerong was on campus.
Made by the students is very impressive. The Construction Technology Pathway Program is helping students build for the future. It's my
All right, I have a link to that at the end of this video, so if you wanted to see more of it, that'd be great. Let's wrap this up. Now, I show that at our official recruiting day that we do on our campus, but honestly, that is the least of it. That's just cool eye candy for the kids to see. If your students don't know about your program by that point, by the time that day comes around, then you're probably not going to do very good in recruiting. As a quick recap, we've talked about recruiting and why it's important to us as teachers. I talked about from order of most important to down the scale, counselors, students, parents, and community. If you want any of my supplemental material, I will have it attached below this YouTube video in the comments section. I'll give you my slides that we're going through right now. I've got the notes that go with it. You can see my Facebook page. You can see that cool promo video I just did, and also my YouTube channel, which I have a ton of stuff on there. I'm here for you. Good teachers share. And I want to be a good teacher. So if you want some individual help, or maybe we can do a little workshop with a few of you, then you just let me know. Take care. Be safe. Best to you.